Hi, I'm Corey Barger, and this is Bassoon Lessons Online. I'm here to help you learn to play the bassoon with more confidence and ease. Hit subscribe so that you don't miss any lessons. Today's topic is dynamics. I want to help you learn to play more effective dynamics and know exactly what is going on when you are trying to change the volume of your bassoon. So if you're not familiar with the term, dynamics refer to the level of loudness, usually, of a particular note. You'll see them written as piano, mezzo forte, forte, fortissimo, pianissimo, anything in between. When we play an instrument like the bassoon, we don't really have the same dynamic range as other instruments do, like the clarinet. We can't play as quietly as the clarinet, no matter how much that may make us jealous. And we can't play as loudly as an instrument like the trombone. One thing that we have to do is to fool people into thinking that we can do this by mostly just setting up a lot of contrast. But the style in which you play can also have a big effect on how the dynamic you're playing is perceived. I'll get to that more later. So first of all, what is the difference between playing piano and playing forte? When you're playing piano, the air is moving quite slowly, and when you're playing forte, the air is moving much faster. You're trying to get a larger amount of air going through the bassoon, and that's going to create an increase in the dynamic. When you're trying to balance these two things, it's very important that you have enough support. You've definitely heard me say this before, but enough support is the number one problem that I see from any student. It's just not sufficient to hold the tone of the bassoon. So, in order to play with a slower airstream, you must have consistent support. I can't emphasize this enough. Otherwise, your note will die and your intonation will just go pew. So, the air must be supported to a good level. You may need to increase the amount of support that you use in a piano dynamic. I tend to advise that people use the maximum amount of support all the time, but I realize that that's not always what happens with people. So, when you're getting to a piano dynamic, just imagine that the air that you use for your normal, like, mezzo forte dynamic is a specific speed. You can think of it as 500 miles an hour, you can think of it as 30 miles an hour, it doesn't really matter that much. To give you a reference point, though, when we sneeze, our sneeze usually comes out at about 200 miles an hour, whereas a cough would be something more around 40. So, speaking, our air moves very slow, something like maybe 5 or 10 miles an hour. So playing is probably in the range of 10 to 40. Let's say that I'm blowing at 30 miles an hour as I play this A-flat. Now I'm going to just imagine that I'm driving in the car and I am taking my foot off of the accelerator so that the car will just slowly decrease in speed. You can see that it gets quieter and it dies after a point. In order for us to get quieter, we have to actually involve the embouchure. You have to balance the involvement of your embouchure with your air. If your embouchure tightens up a little bit, the pitch may go sharp. You have to slow your air down enough that keeps the pitch stable. So getting to a really soft dynamic is always a balance between the embouchure involvement and the speed of the air. You'll find certain notes that just don't want to go below a certain threshold. But this is something that you can practice in your long tone practice to really extend the end of your diminuendos so that you can get really, really, really quiet. We're not really going to get clarinet level quiet, unfortunately, because we've got to make sure that these two reeds vibrate together. But we can get a lot quieter than what I just demonstrated. So let's do this in reverse. We want to get louder. You want to increase the speed of your air. So just imagine that you're accelerating in the car. What do you hear? You hear a little bit of a distortion of the pitch and a little bit of a distortion of the sound. I'm trying to force a larger amount of air through. I'm not really using a more aggressive airstream like I would for an accent, but it is getting faster. In order for me to really take advantage of this forte, I have to open up my embouchure to make sure that there's more room for the air and that the reed can vibrate more. You can experiment with how loud and how soft you can get during your long tone practice, but use this speed guideline to help you figure out where your average speeds are, where your lowest speed is before things start to drop off, and really think about the relationship between your embouchure and the level of sound. Listen very carefully for any distortion and any differences in pitch. If you're opening up your embouchure as you get louder, but it's not balanced with the amount of air you're putting through, the pitch is going to get lower. And we definitely do not want to have inconsistent intonation when you're trying to change dynamic. So always work with a tuner on your stand if it's not something that you're very attuned to picking up on yet. And that's something that will get better with practice as well. Hit subscribe so you don't miss any lessons, and please share with anybody you think may benefit from bassoon lessons online. Thanks so much.